asexual reproduction in organisms. Reproduction is the fundamental feature to all known life. Each individual organism exists as the result of reproduction. The known methods of reproduction are broadly grouped into two main types, sexual and asexual. Asexual reproduction is a mode of reproduction by which offspring arise from a single parent and inherit the genes of that parent only. There are several types of asexual reproduction, such as 1. Binary fission, 2. Which In binary fission, the parent organism is replaced by two daughter organisms because it literally divides into two. A good example of the same is a single-celled organism like paramecium. In this case, the process of reproduction begins with the division of its nucleus into nuclei. This is followed by division of its body into two, each part receiving a nucleus. Finally, two paramecium are born from the single parent cell. In case of unicellular organisms, cell division or fission leads to the creation of new individuals. Many different patterns of binary fission have been observed. Many bacteria and protozoa simply split into two equal halves during cell division. On the other hand, some single-celled organisms, such as malarial parasite Plasmodium, divide into many daughter cells simultaneously by multiple fission. We now move on to another type of asexual reproduction called regeneration. Simple animals like planaria can be cut into any number of pieces and each piece grows into a complete organism. This process is called vegetative propagation. It is called vegetative propagation as the reproduction takes place through the vegetative parts of a plant. Another example of vegetative propagation comes across in case of the plant Bryophyllum, where the buds produced in the notches along its leaf fall on the soil and develop into new plants. Vegetative propagation is also seen in case of potatoes. You must have seen scars on potatoes, which are also known as eyes. If a potato is cut into small pieces along with the eye, buried in the soil and watered properly, a new potato plant There are certain cells that split via the process of budding, resulting in a mother and daughter cell. The offspring organism is smaller than the parent. A good example of this is baker's yeast. These organisms multiply every few hours if sufficient nutrients are made available to them. The small projection coming out from the yeast cell is called a bud. The bud gradually grows and gets detached from the parent cell to form a new yeast cell. If this process continues, a large number of yeast cells are produced. budding also takes place at a multicellular level. In case of animals, budding takes place in hydra. In each hydra, there may be one or more bulges. These bulges are the developing new individuals called buds. The new individuals develop as outgrowths from a single parent. You must have seen the slimy green patches in ponds or other stagnant water bodies. These are called algae. When nutrients and water is available, algae grow and multiply rapidly by a process called fragmentation. An alga breaks into two or more fragments, which grow into new individuals. This process continues and they cover a large area in a short period of time. Fragmentation is a form of asexual reproduction, where a new organism grows from a fragment of the parent. Each fragment develops into a mature, fully grown individual. The last type of asexual reproduction that we are going to discuss is called spore formation. Spores are asexual reproductive bodies. Each spore is covered by a hard protective coat to withstand unfavorable conditions such as high temperature and low humidity. A spore germinates and develops into a new individual. This A common fungi is a good example with regards to the process of spore formation. Aspergillus species are common contaminants of starchy foods such as bread and potatoes. They commonly grow as molds on the surface of a substrate as a result of the high oxygen tension. The blobs that can be seen growing on the surface are called sporangia, which contain cells or spores that eventually burst open and disperse in the air to give birth to new individuals. The process of asexual reproduction is their part of the nature which helps organisms reproduce and therefore survive.